Hello everyone, this is Diana from Artemis in Love, and today I'm going to show you how to make Korker ribbon by baking it in the oven. And we are going to use dowel rods, and I went to Walmart and bought one long dowel rod. I cut them into about 9-inch strips, and I literally used, I marked it off with a ruler and I literally cut it with a knife. So, I got several, so I would buy two of those. I have some longer ones that I had from before, but these are about, I believe, 3/8-inch dowel rods. And we are going to try three different methods. We're going to try with starch, hairspray, and with nothing. I'm setting my oven to 300 degrees, and you'll hear it beep here in a second to let us know that it's ready. I seen a lot of posts saying that people use 275 degrees, but I don't feel that is enough. So I'm using 300 degrees, and we're gonna try baking it for 30 minutes. So it gets nice and hard and crispy, and 275 for about 25 minutes doesn't seem to work with me and my oven. So you may need to adjust your temperature and your time according to how your oven is. And I can't guarantee that it will be completely done with my temperature and my time. So like I said, just adjust it. So what we're gonna do here is I'm starting out with one color here. We're gonna start out with this yellow. I'm using 3/8-inch ribbon in three different colors. So I'm just gonna light the end, and we're gonna take this clothespin here. And we're gonna do this at an angle. So I'm gonna just angle it right there and then clothespin it down. And then all we're gonna do is twist it, okay? Okay, so we're gonna twist it, and the rule is you're not supposed to let the ribbon touch each other, because you don't want it to melt onto each other. So what you're gonna do is just leave a little tiny space, and then you're gonna move the dowel rod, and then just hold the ribbon in place and kind of maneuver it so you can still have a space here. And when I measured it, it's anywhere from 16 to 18 inches for each 9-inch dowel rod. So I'm just gonna finish this up real quick, and we just keep on turning. Like I said, after a while, after you do this for a while, it gets a lot easier, and you could do this a lot faster. And you want to probably get a lot, do a lot at one time, so you don't have to do it over again, because it is a long process to bake everything. So I'm just gonna finish this up real quick, and at the very end, let me grab my scissors. You're just gonna trim it and light it, and then put it on. What I did is I just went like this, and then I'm just turning it. And so now we have one done. So what I'm doing is, because we have six dowel rods, I'm going to do two colors of each. If you want to make a nice, really fluffy one, then I would recommend doing three of each. But just for the purpose of this video, I'm going to do two of each. I'm not going to have you sit here and watch me do every single one, because that's going to get kind of boring. So I'm going to go ahead and finish these up. And then I'll come back after I'm all complete. And then I'll show you what we're gonna do next. Okay, so I have them all done, And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to spray most of them here. With this one, I'm going to mark it that this is done with starch, just so we know for later. So you don't wanna do this directly on the cookie sheet that you're going to bake it on. You wanna do it on something else. So I'm gonna shake my starch real quick and I'm gonna lightly spray it. And I'm gonna turn it and spray one more time. You don't wanna go too crazy with this. Okay, so we have that one, and this one I'm gonna spray with starch as well. Okay. And this is so messy. I'm gonna use hairspray, and you wanna use like a really strong hairspray, and I have this Extra Firm Control Tresemme. It's number 4 on the levels, so this is pretty good. We're gonna go ahead and mark this hairspray. And then spray it once. Spray one more time, and that one's done. So the next one, I'm gonna spray this one with hairspray. Front and back. And then we're gonna do nothing with these. So we'll just put N and N. Let me see if I marked this one. Yep. Okay, so I have them all marked. Give me a second while I go get the cookie sheet. Okay, now we have the cookie sheet, and we're just going to put these in here. And you don't want it touching the pan itself, but that's pretty easy to not do since you have these clips in here. Just gonna move this. And then stick this one here. And if it makes you feel more comfortable, you can line it with foil. And also, when you're using, I just wanted to throw this in real quick. When you're using white ribbon, you want to be careful with your baking time, because if you bake it too long, it can get burnt and have like a burnt look to the white, which makes it like almost brownish color. So please be careful with the white. Do not overdo it. You can also do that to these. So just do not overcook, but cook enough so they're crispy enough. So we're gonna try this. 3 different methods with nothing, hairspray and starch, 300 degrees in the oven for half an hour. We're all done. I just took it out of the oven. The timer went off. You're supposed to let these dry, or you're supposed to let these cool down, but I want to take a peek and see how they did. Ooh, really hot. Gonna unwind it just a tad. That doesn't look too bad. So this is one with starch. What's this one is with hairspray. That's not too bad. And then I really want to check the one with nothing. Not too bad either. It does feel a little bit looser. It doesn't feel as tight as the other ones. And I would assume that this with nothing on it could actually go back into the oven probably for another 5 or 10 minutes just with nothing on it. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. Yeah, because you could tell this is a little bit more crunchy. It seems more stable than this. So, we know if you put nothing on it, that it should go back in just for a little bit. So, these need to stay and these need to come off. I'm gonna move these pads. Okay, so these are the ones that we wanna keep. And there is something with one of these. Now, if you look right here, I don't know if you could see this, but I intentionally added a drop of hot glue and let it dry so you could see what happens when you try to put something in the oven when it's already glued. So if you want to put a bow in there, you do not want it glued. You do not want to glue it yet. So this is what it turns out looking like. It's not good. Just melted. So I'm not gonna spray it with starch. I'm going to actually spray it with hairspray on every single one of these now. It's just a little tiny bit. We'll flip them all over. And then I'm gonna let them completely cool. I'm gonna let these completely cool now, and then I'm gonna put the ones with nothing on them at all back in the oven for about 10 minutes. And then once that's all done, then I'll come back. All right, now the ones with nothing on it are finally done. I'm just gonna take a peek one more time. Yeah, the ones with nothing at all, they're just not as good. I can already tell by taking this off that they're not gonna stay. They're not gonna keep their hold. So, let me tighten this back up. What I'm gonna do is, this is pretty hot. Where's that pad? Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put these let me get rid of the ones that we already did. This one's no, and this one's no. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna spray it with hairspray now, and hopefully that's gonna help keep it, keep its hold, keep its shape. And we'll go ahead and start letting that dry. And we're gonna start unraveling these, because even after those 10 minutes, they're not so hot anymore. We're gonna unravel, and what I do is I just turn a little bit. Let's see which ones these are. This one is hairspray, okay. So I'm just gonna turn, and some of it might get stuck onto the dowel. So I'm going to just move it just slightly and just work its way off of the dowel. And then I'm gonna go like this and try pulling it off. There we go. So that one's all done. So now we're gonna move to the next one. And this one is starch. And this one has that little piece of glue on there. So I'm gonna just work it off. There we go. And I'm just gonna keep that separate. And this one is starch again. And I'm just gonna work it off of the rod once again, slowly. Just pulling it apart from there. Oh, so what you don't wanna do, you don't wanna bunch it up. So I'm just twisting a little bit. There we go. And one more. This one doesn't seem like it turned out as well as this one. Let's see here in a second. To be honest, I think the hairspray worked the best. I can fill it. It feels pretty crunchy. It just seems like it held its shape a lot better. This is one with starch. Maybe I didn't put as much starch on this one. This one's with starch as well. But overall, I'm gonna recommend hairspray. Hairspray before and after. Definitely hairspray. Anyway, since we have that done, I'm gonna move everything to the side here. And we're still letting the other stuff dry. Now this is sitting at approximately 9 inches, remember? So three of these squares here, 1, 2, 3, it's going to be 3 inches, and I'm cutting these into 3-inch strips. So 1, 2, 3. And it's just a little bit longer, and that's fine. I'm just gonna cut it at the very end. There we go. So here's our first cuts here. So I'm gonna do this again. 3 inches for everything to make our bow. That's just about right. All right, so I'll go ahead and fast forward through this part. Okay, I got those all done. Now I'm gonna unravel these. Still baking with nothing, it still came out pretty good. This one's really loose, it feels like, after we added that hairspray. So they're gonna cut these up. Okay, so I have them all done, and funny thing, when I was cutting, my scissors, these are Fiskars, completely fell apart. So I tried hot gluing it back together. Obviously that's not gonna work. Maybe I might super glue it. I don't know. I think I just need a new pair of scissors because I screwed them over anyways. So I went ahead and just grabbed some cheap hair cutting scissors that I could find real quick so I could finish my video. So now what we're going to do is we're going to stack these. We're going to go find the middle the best you can and just stack it. And what you want to do is keep your hands down here because you don't want to... you don't want to push it all the way down yet when you string it. So all I'm doing is just pushing down to where my fingers are stopping it. And I found that this is the best way. It's the easiest. I know other people have different methods, but this way it's completely sewn together. You don't have to worry about it coming apart. So just gonna finish doing this real quick. If you're gonna have more ribbon, I would use a longer needle. So it's really poofy right there on top. If you're gonna use more ribbon, I would use a longer needle. And I'm gonna pull this all the way through. And one thing I'm gonna tell you is make sure your knot down there is really big, really large, because it will come through on you, and that's happened to me before. So I'm just gonna sew back through the middle. And this is something that's common that happens, is you're gonna bring a loop with you. So you do the best you can to not bring a loop with you. So I'm just gonna go back through a few more times. And this is already stuck on this loop, I can tell. Come on through, please. And I'm just gonna keep doing this. Keep sewing it. And we'll go ahead and end it right here. But make sure you have it very secure. You just want to make sure that these are not going to come apart. So I'm just tying it off, knotting it off right here. And I see you, loop. Okay, so I'm gonna use my handy dandy hair cutting scissors. And there we go, you see that? And if you use more ribbon, then it'll be even more poofy. So what I'm gonna do is take this, let me grab a lighter. Okay, this is approximately 2 inches, and I'm just gonna line this real quick, and I have a video on this if you need to learn how to line alligator clips. Otherwise you could just watch me do it real quick. There we go, all done. Okay, so I'm thinking I want this to be the top and for this to be the bottom. So I'm gonna lay it across, and what I like to do is lay it across a few of the ribbons instead of just one. So here's my, well, I'm gonna need to glue this first. Don't come up all the way, because you're gonna need this for, oh. Dang it. You're going to need this for pinching, so don't come up all the way. And I'm just going to go like this and lay it across two of them. press down. And there we go. Ta-da! You can try poofing it up a little bit. All these ends do need to be lit. So I'm just gonna go like this and go across them quickly. And you can do this right after you cut if you want to. Otherwise, you can do it during this time, and they're all there right next to each other, so you can just keep going like this. I like to do it this way because I can go really fast lighting all the ends. Just make sure I get every single one of them. Do-do-do. So it looks like I got every single one of them, and here is our Korker bow that's nice and fluffy. Like I said, if you want it fluffier, go ahead and use more ribbon. And I'm gonna finish it off with some hairspray and let that dry. So kind of fluff it to where you want it to be, rearrange it, do whatever you want to do, and then give it a nice spray. Don't do too much. There we go. Now here is the Korker bow that is completely finished, and it is approximately 3 inches. All right, so we're all done with this tutorial. Please leave a like, subscribe, or comment. If you have any questions, message me or comment. And thank you for watching. Bye.